opportunity to indulge myself to some extent and just show you a few slides and talk in a very general, non-scientific way about the work I've been doing. Now, the reason I was in Brunei was not so much to study Nepenthes themselves, but to study the animals that live inside them. And this is a photograph of the inside of a picture of Nepenthes rafflesiana. I'm not sure with the light how clearly you can see that, but there's a large dead cricket here, a couple of small moths, which have been caught by the pitcher. What I was studying were these things, and these are the pupae of mosquitoes. And it's very hard for you to see, but there are also some larvae around here. A lot of the animals that go into the pitchers eat the dead insects that are caught by the pitchers. But there are a small number of animals that colonize the pitchers that eat other animals swimming or living inside the pitcher. So you get, in any given pitcher, a simple food web. And this is a food web diagram. All food web diagrams have at the bottom the primary producers or the primary energy source. And in pitcher communities, that is the insects which have just drowned or suspended debris of old broken up insects and microorganisms. Now you also get groups of animals which feed on these two basic nutrient sources. This is a group of mosquito species. Some of you who've ever had much to do with mosquitoes will know the Tryptoroides. The Culex species can be a bit annoying sometimes. This is a mite called Zwickia. These are two species of midges. This is a non-biting midge and this is a biting midge. Non-biting midges are, in my opinion, much more advanced organisms than biting midges because they don't bite. And these are the larvae of two flies. Feeding on those are the larvae of two mosquitoes, or a large predatory mosquito here and a smaller one, not quite a mosquito, but closely related. And at the top of the food web, or the food chain, is a species of ant, which lives only in the pitchers of Nepenthes bicalcarata. You can see at the bottom that this is a particular diagram for the food web from Nepenthes bicalcarata pitchers. Now, the lines on the diagram show feeding interactions. So any line, such as this one here, shows that the species at the top of the line feeds on the resource or species at the bottom of the line. So this is a diagram showing all of the feeding interactions between the species in the community. It's a similar food web from Nepenthes rafflesiana pitchers in Brunei. You can see that it's a lot simpler. Fewer species, there are only two mosquitoes, one midge, one fly, and one mite, and one predator at the top. So different Nepenthes species have different food webs. And I was also looking to see whether different habitats support different food webs within the same Nepenthes species. And I was testing a theory that food chains, let's just go back a moment, the food chain is basically a list or a chain of species in a list of feeding interactions. So in this case, the longest food chain is probably from here to here to here to here. That would be the longest food chain in the web. There's a theory that states that food chain length will be shorter in habitats that suffer more disturbances. And this is a very difficult hypothesis to test in a rainforest where the animals are numerous, unidentified and mobile. But in Nepenthes pitchers, this is very easy work to do. The pitchers are all very small and easy to work with. And that was why I chose Nepenthes as the habitat unit that I studied while I was in Brunei. I spent a lot of time working on this species in particular, Nepenthes bicalcarata. And it's obviously famous because of these two thorns. I didn't spend much time working on those. I spent a lot of time looking at the food web and also a species of ant, which I'm sure some of you are familiar with now, which nests in the tendrils, which are hollow, and feeds by swimming in the pitcher fluid and pulling out any excess prey items caught by the pitchers. If the pitcher catches too much prey, the whole lot goes putrid. And it can sometimes kill the pitcher, but not the whole plant. In Nepenthes bicalcarata, that's a problem because it relies very heavily on the food web of organisms inside the pitcher to keep recycling all the nutrients that come into it. In other species, such as Nepenthes mirabilis and Nepenthes rafflesiana, it's not so important. This is Nepenthes cingalana. This is in the state Sumatran province of Jambi, near the highest mountain of Sumatra, Mount Kerinci. And the Nepenthes cingalana around there is particularly robust with a nice wide peristome, deep colours, and long teeth pointing into the mouth. It's a very nice plant. Look at the next slide. And of course, the main reason to go to Gunung Tujuh is to see this. I love this species, not just because it's so weird, but because I no longer feel compelled to go into the middle of Irian Gyra and look for Nepenthes glossae. It's made life a lot easier for me, although I still might try and do that one. But the dome shape of the picture, not exactly unique, but highly unusual. And it's a very threatened plant, as far as I can tell. There's only a small population there, maybe one somewhere else. But the good thing is access to this site is now much more difficult because it's a lot harder to cross the lake these days. There used to be a guy living up there with a canoe, but he's now moved down to the local village, and so there's now no canoe wrapped up in the lake. So that makes crossing the lake pretty hard. Very unusual pictures of the structure. We decided to call this one the Nepenthes jacquelineae, after my wife this time. Next slide, please. When it climbs up into the trees, the pitcher structure can change quite markedly. This is a very robust plant. This pitch is about 20, 25 centimetres. See how it gets bulbous in the middle and then cylindrical above. It's quite an unusual feature of this plant. Most pitchers don't look like that. It's only unusually large, robust climbing plants that do. Next slide, please. And just in case you're wondering who Jacqueline is, that's her doing what she does best, drinking wine and sitting on verandas and taking it easy while I go and find unusual Nepenthes.
Yeah, 18 years ribosomal DNA sequences. Yes.
Drosera has a worldwide distribution, but the vast majority of species are found in South Hemispheres, especially in the Australia and South Africa and South America. Drosera have after private traps and capture their prey with mobile granular hairs that are present on the adduction side of the bees. Aldabanda and Dionair share a similar trapping mechanism called a snap trap. Aldabanda is a floating aquatic species and it is found throughout the Old World and the Northern and East America and Australia. While Dionaea is a terrestrial plant and it is endemic to marshy habits on the coastal plains of North and South Carolina, United States. So the evolution of leaves with trap systems from non-carnivorous plants to carnivorous plants is a mysterious and very interesting topic in plant science. The correlations between active flat paper trap and slab traps are ambiguous because there are no reports of the morphologically intermediate leaves. Africa contains about 30 species, and also in South Africa, 30 species are found. And in northern hemispheres, even though there are wide distribution, less than or around 10 species, only 10 species are distributed in northern part. Droseraceae is basal, while the clade including all the other African species, especially indica, clustered as a terminal position. Indica likely expands their distribution from Australia to Africa. Therefore, there are three different species lineages in Africa. Especially at the molecular level, nobody cannot imagine what genes were involved in the evolution of the trap systems. So we hypothesize that trap system evolved by the gain of function. It means some genes got a new function and the trap system evolved. If so, when we disrupt the gene by mutation, carnivorous plants will lose their trap system and become similar to a non-carnivorous plant.
Middle of the week during the experiment, so